Remembering 1916 marks the centenary of the First World War in a very special way. It seeks to recreate the lost world of those who lived and died on the Western Front in 1916, to travel back in time to see that world through the eyes of those who once inhabited it, whatever their country, sensitive to our common humanity and shared loss. Giving new life to distant voices and presenting exceptional artifacts against the background of the experiences of those who lived through such a momentous year has been a very special experience for all of those involved. 1916 was a pivotal year in the conflict, containing three of the most significant battles of the war: Verdun, Jutland, and the Somme. For Britain, it also marked the point when the proud tradition of a volunteer army was abandoned. To find certain countries more guilty than others of the causation of the war, to apportion blame for the suffering, to examine motives and responsibilities, to determine whether the ordinary soldiers were indeed lions led by donkeys, none of these form any part of the purpose of this exhibition. It is the now distant voices of ordinary men and women, often leading extraordinary lives, that are central to our presentation, together with the artifacts they had around them and the memories they left behind.
Je partis de Deauville un peu avant minuit, dans la petite auto de Rouvert. Avec son chauffeur, nous étions trois. Nous dîmes adieu à toute une époque.
Verglaste Augen, blutgeronnen, zerspellte Hirne, ausgespiene Eingeweide.
How I dislike you, dealer in white feathers, insulter, self-appointed, of all the men you meet, not dressed in uniform. Oh, exasperating woman, I'd like to wring your neck,
as you really would. In khaki tunic, Sam Brown belt and all, and standing there and laughing down at me, because they tell me, dear, that you are dead.
Well, fond heart, I think I shall turn
because
in now.
I can no longer.
I feel much better today and slept quite well last night. I hope you are keeping very well, darling. All my fondest and deepest love. Ever thine, John.
Remembering 1916 has been acclaimed by historians and by tens of thousands of visitors for its emphasis on the universality of the human spirit, its deeply moving, personal stories of men and women from all the nations of the conflict, and its wonderful artifacts. The exhibition is a poignant and a very special centenary memorial.